Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel and thank you for the recent subscribes. Keep it on, thanks. In this video we are going through how to install DVWA and a small part I will focus on brute force login page with Hydra. Let's see how to configure DVWA, that stands for Damn Vulnerable Web Application. This web application is made with tons of vulnerabilities, some of them with documentation and link related and some to be discovered. In order to make people practice and understand how things work to secure and exploit a web server, not only for professional security but also for developer. To run it on your machine there are various paths that of installation, but the most quicker and effortless is pulling and run the image available on Docker. This image is vulnerables / web - DVWA. To pull and run the image you need to run this command suggested by the terminal in case you don't have them already available on the machine, which are sudo apt install docker.io and podman - docker. Once you have retrieved this dependency, you're almost ready to pull the image. The last thing that you have to do is to modify the file shortnames.conf, in which you insert the string that will be used by the command to pull the image. Now we are ready to pull the image, therefore we run the command docker pull vulnerables / web - DVWA. Let's run the command copy from the page that we previously seen, that is docker - run - rn, that stands for remote connection, - et for running some configurations such as -p8080 to map the port 80 of your machine with the one of the container, and last the image to run. Now that Docker task the web server is up, we can go to a browser and insert the URL localhost. This URL will bring us to first login page of the web application. The username and the password are the default one written in the web page documentation, that is admin and password respectively. The first page that the web server will show us is the setup check, in which we have to click on the button create reset database. This button will trigger the script which will create the user's password and other stuff in order to make the web application full responsive. There are ton of things to make practice with some pages with different link to understand the vulnerabilities. In future I think that I will make video on almost all the topics once I'm confident with them. As you can see, there is also a section with DVWA security where you can set the security level of the web application. For now it's set to low, but you can put it further till level impossible. Now let's focus on brute force with Hydra in order to get access to the login page of the section brute force. Hydra is a tool that helps you to brute force different service. In this case I will insert in the Hydra command the request intercepted by brute suite, because I have a cookie set on it in which there is the PHP session ID that was generated before with the previous login, and this will allow me to get access to the web application and brute force the pages inside without any restriction. There are different ways to brute force a login page, but the most important thing is the word list file that is, sometimes you need to modify it in order to reduce the time to guess during the brute force. In this case, I will use the parameter admin for the password and the word list file. Before I run the fast command, I would like to show you that with the option dash capital L and dash capital P, you can put the word list file to iterate and insert the base URL, the module that is http://get-form, the URL request, and the column with the parameter to iterate, in this case user and password, and the cookie to use. But this could take you a lot of time, thus it's always better to try and to guess the username in order to reduce the brute force time. Therefore, let's run the fast command. In this case, because we know that there is a user named admin, I will insert this user. Now I will use also the command dash F, which indicates that as soon as the password is found, the brute force will stop. So I replace the dash option, dash capital L option with dash L admin, and I also insert the dash F and I run the command. As you can see, we have found the password. If you enjoyed the content, please leave a like and subscribe. See you in the future.